For the second time in 6.5 months, a major disaster occurred due to the eruption of Indonesia's Mount Marapi volcano. While the first instance on December 3rd of 2023 resulted in the deaths of 24 individuals due to an unexpected phreatomagmatic eruption of the volcano, the latest disaster is slightly more indirect, as that aforementioned December 3rd eruption produced pyroclastic flows which incinerated an area of 0.9 square kilometers on the northwest slope of the volcano. With all regional vegetation in the area killed off, there was nothing to hold back any heavy rains, which when combined with the centimeters to decimeters thick of ash Marapi has produced in the last 6.5 months, resulted in a destructive Lahar. The danger began to escalate around 6 p.m. local time on May 11th when an unusually heavy downpour began, which was sustained for several hours. Within only 3 hours, 13.8 centimeters or 5.43 inches had fallen. This amount of rain quickly saturated the ground in Sumatra's local rainforests, causing water to instead flow downslope after a portion had been absorbed by plants. This began resulting in sections of various slopes around the island beginning to act like a viscous liquid, slowly creeping downslope. Many of these slopes then collapsed, resulting in destructive landslides and floods, which wiped out homes and roads, as seen in this footage courtesy of the Explore West Sumatra YouTube channel, who you should check out, by the way. As a result of this danger, a Lahar warning was sent out at 9:03 p.m. indicating an imminent danger of a destructive Lahar occurring. There was only one problem. A Lahar early warning system had not been fully set up yet, as workers were in the early stages of implementing such a system, so as a result, the warning was not automatically sent to any citizens. Thus, only 54 minutes later, a Lahar began heading down the mountain at a speed of 50 kilometers per hour, and as it did this, it continued piling on more and more material like an avalanche tumbling down a mountain. Reaching a height of 10 meters or 32.8 feet, what appeared to be a wall of wet concrete filled with large debris overtopped its riverbanks, quickly wiping out or damaging dozens of structures within 350 meters or 1148 feet of the stream's edge. As a result, viscous material cascaded down roads, even reaching the second story on some structures, with Lahar continuing for the next 2 hours. Sadly, this resulted in the deaths of 18 people. Due to the potential for further Lahars to occur in the same sector of Mount Marapi, the already damaged towns were evacuated. I don't blame the government or the volcanological agency in Indonesia for the deaths which occurred. It was simply bad timing, as construction and hardware projects simply take a minimum amount of time to complete, and this timetable was just unfortunate enough to not be completed before it would be first needed. Remember, please stay clear of any triages in central Sumatra at this time, and be on the lookout for a faint rumbling sound or the sound of glass breaking. These sounds can indicate that a nearby landslide is taking place. The reason I am covering this disaster is that without the pyroclastic flows and ashfall from Marapi's December 3, 2023 through the present eruption, the odds are that no one would have become a casualty due to the Lahars, as this disaster would have been far smaller. While the ongoing eruption of Marapi may have reached the threshold of a very low NVEI-3, in my opinion, it would be best to classify its ongoing eruption as a VEI-2. VEI-2s represent the most common size for a volcanic eruption, and even these fairly small eruptions can create destructive Lahars given a specific set of circumstances. All that needs to occur is for increased instability on a volcano slope or summit to occur, even during a purely effusive eruption, or for even a negligible amount of ash to be deposited during an explosive eruption to potentially set the stage for a destructive Lahar to occur. For example, while the 2006 VEI-1 eruption of Mayon killed no one, it deposited enough ash and lava that by the time the Category 4 typhoon struck the volcano, it resulted in Lahars which killed more than 1,200 people. So, please stay vigilant, as Lahars are responsible for 26% of all volcano-related deaths tallied between 1500 and 2017.